To see what's there in the ground, we have to look a different direction. And I have to show you something here in California first. I have to show you this. And maybe I should draw it out for you. Let's do that. There we go. That's just a rough drawing. But I'm going to turn it off now so you can see it as it was built into the plate. Now, this is 300 miles long. The Grand Canyon is on the back side of this thing. On this side is 29 Palms Military Base, Bombing Range, U.S. Marine Training Base. On this side, Area 51 in the nuke test site that I just showed you. Nuke test site right here, Area 51 right here. So one side, 29 Palms, the other side, nuke test site and Area 51. And right in the middle of this thing is this. Edwards Air Force Base, where we launch a lot of our big bombers and nuclear stuff from. Now, why am I showing this thing to you? This is a 300-mile-long star fort, ancient, built by people out of mountains themselves. Area 51 on one side, 29 Palms on the other, Edwards Air Force Base in the middle, and it points right out here to the tip of the San Andreas. That is the San Andreas, in case you didn't know. Let me show you. Here's California. San Andreas comes down, goes over to the very tip of it. The 300-mile-long bastion fort, built God knows how long ago. The military has to be aware because they built the base in the middle and on either side, and the Grand Canyon's blown out on the back side of this thing. So what does that have to do with the earthquake next to it over here? Well, we got our geothermal plant and all our weird scraping going on there on the ground. But if we back this out, you're going to see there's two more of these things. This one's the visible one that's more easily visible. There's two more, one here and one here. All three have a blowout on the back side. Grand Canyon blown out on the back side of this one. I just showed it to you. It's there. The military bases are in the middle of the tip and on either side. This one, Salt Lake City's on the back side. And what's up in the tip? Another military base. A huge one. See this? This is the Sierra Army Ammo Depot with all their underground bunkers. So there's one here, military base in the middle, and on both sides. There's one here, military base in the middle, and of course, on both sides. We could get over here, what's on the east side of here, and the biggest open pit mines in the United States for copper extraction and precious metals. Now, the third one is somewhat easier to see. It's still here in the mountains themselves. This one, military base. This one, military base. What's in the tip of this one? Well, first of all, on the back side, you'll see it's blown out with a giant crater. It goes back to Yellowstone back here. This is Yellowstone right here, Lake Yellowstone. So on the back side of this one's Yellowstone. Back side of this one's Salt Lake. Back side of this one's Grand Canyon. One, two, three. And what's at the tip? Not a military base. You ready? This is the kicker. Right down here, right in the tip. Let me turn on borders, labels, and places. Look what's here. Not a military base. The Schwab Distribution Center. No. Yes. The Facebook data center and the Apple data centers. You got me? The Facebook and Apple data centers are in the middle of that one. The Sierra Army Ammo Depot is in the middle of this one. And the supervolcano that I already showed you with the big oval. And here is the military base, Edwards Air Force Base. Military base in the middle of that one. Military base in the middle of that one. And you could arguably say that it's a military base in the middle of this one as well. Certainly military industrial complex. Now, that's not chance or coincidence. That's really there. This is real. This is really happening. This is real. Is this really happening? Yes. This is really happening. That's really real. Like, really real. Well, as real can be. Now, we may be in some kind of matrix reality where this never happened. But other than that, that stuff's real. So the military knows. And then to get the scraping on the backside, come on. How many times are we going to see this around the world, the scrapeouts and the pit mines, where they're trying to get into the end of this stuff? And the military bases prove it. Somebody's got to know. There can't be chance. The Facebook data center. Come on. And I define this all by chance. Let's carry on. Is your mind blown? Is your mind blown? Because that's real. there was some kind of civilization that existed a long time ago that had the ability to sculpt and shape mountains that for hundreds of miles that makes a military base look like a little speck on a map. And the military's aware, and that's why they built the military base there. But who lived a long time ago that was able to control this stuff? All right. Let's get into California. The earthquakes are going down along the California coast and down along the California border. I already showed you the oval-shaped supervolcano Sierra Army Ammo Depot tip of the giant star fort there with the earthquakes. We go down across, we go down to the nuke sites on the edge of the star fort. Over along the coast, what's up here? There's a giant stack of earthquakes. Should we go look it up? The geysers of California. This update is about to get even more repetitive than it already is or has been. So let's put the coordinates in and show you what's there. We're going to Northwest California along the coast of the San Andreas, next to the San Andreas. These are drill points. And the drill points are for steam. The steam is coming up along the edge of the Clear Lake volcanic field. And they have pipelines here to collect the steam, where they drill into the ground and they actually inject water into the ground. They do injection here. So they inject water down into the hot ground that doesn't have enough water in it to steam to get the steam. And they don't just inject water. They inject human sewage into the ground. Leave the nasties in the ground. Up comes the steam. Turns the turbines. That's on the edge of Clear Lake volcanic field here and Mount Kanakti, the volcano in the middle. So that's where the stack of earthquakes is. The geysers. There's a few lone quakes, 1.6, 1.4, on the north side going up to the north, all the way up to the spot where I've got the warning. Let's go back to the USGS map now. We got a warning now going here for 5.0 level activity over the next 7 days. And then look which way the San Andreas goes. It goes down to the south, right through those areas that I just told you, right? Through the Bay Area, down to the south, through the creeping section. Everybody knows about the San Andreas. What you don't know about are the drill points right along it. Okay, let's go into the Bay Area. I want to go look these up, just go see what's there. I'm sure my viewers in San Francisco would be interested. By the way, somebody told me that they have a position or opening for some kind of DJ there in San Francisco and told me that I should come there and apply for the job. I'm like, look, unless the DJ is going to allow playing a vaporwave and some other weird stuff, I don't know, man. Hey, look where the airport is. It's right next to the International Airport. Is there anything else that's here that's worth mentioning besides the International Airport? How about the giant refinery that's right there? Nothing could go wrong there. All that's missing now is a giant power plant in the area to seal the deal of it being a human-induced earthquake. Very low frequency of some kind. What do we have going on over here? What's this? Some kind of rail yard of some kind. Maybe. Just military of some kind. It's fine. Please, God, no. If we have military base here, I'm just going to just back on out. And just we're just going to get on out of here. Yeah, we're at the Port Chicago Naval Magazine. Boop-a-da-boop. Aye, aye, sir. All right. Let's go over and look along the coast. Let's get away from the Naval Magazine. I already showed you the Sierra Army Ammo Depot. Last thing I need to do is get a bunch of sailors upset with me. Okay. What's over here on the west side? We're going from... Are you serious? Okay, look. We're below the other airport. Look at this. I'm not kidding. We're below the other airport. Okay, if you didn't want me to think that there's any kind of conspiracy going on below the airports, you're going to have a hard time convincing me that there's not a conspiracy going on underneath the airports. I don't know if you want me to move there, man. If I move there, I'm going to get some concrete boots, you know what I mean? Find me out in the harbor. Find out they don't float. Okay, let's go down. Let's get out of here, man. Feeling the heat. Let's just roll on out of here. We're going to low ride on out of here, guys. Put the seat back and just keep on driving. All right. Saratoga Gap Open Space Preserve. Nothing could go wrong in an open preserve, right? There wouldn't be anything here that could go wrong. Let's go take a look and see what's nearby. Again, houses nestled out here into the hillside. That's okay. Anything else? Those power lines? Vineyards. Those are vineyards? Wow. Somebody's living life high on the hog. Look at that winery. Jeez. Oh, wait. A giant pit mine quarry. Right next to it. Is this listed as a blast? No, it's listed as a 4.8 kilometer depth quake. So there's something going on down below here. It's coming up to the pit mine quarry. They usually don't do these pit mine quarries unless there's something worth getting. So let's just see what's here. Do we have any kind of like giant... And you got the preserve there too on the edge. So you got the preserve. You've got the pit mine. The only thing missing now is an ancient structure of some kind that they're mining out to get the ancient geopolymer. Or to get into it, but I would think that they're just taking the material and remixing it. What's this? Okay, we got more parks. Okay, anytime I see a giant pit mine, you got an earthquake right next to the pit mine. And then you got the San Andreas right there. I don't know what to tell you guys. I don't know if it's a good idea to be doing that kind of mining right along the one of the more active faults, right? Wouldn't you think you probably wouldn't want to do any kind of plate weakening at the surface at all? See, this is why you get in trouble. You start talking about this kind of stuff, and people get upset. People who are, you know, rich and powerful. Okay, let's go over across to the quarry blast. Okay, we don't need to go over to a quarry blast. It's labeled as a quarry blast. We'll trust them that it's a quarry blast. As we get down south, let's just wrap this up and just tell everybody. Two lines of quakes. One coming down the creeping section of the San Andreas, jumping over into the valley here. Let's go look this one up. Kolinga. Well, this is a perfect way to end the update. Let's go over to Kolinga and just look it up. You guys should do this yourselves. Put the coordinates in and look it up yourself. Now, I know there's a program that does that now, but I don't know if they're going to tell you about the drill points nearby, right? So, like, you got a program that looks up an earthquake epicenter. It's going to go like this, maybe, or like this, but it's not going to go like this. What the hell is that? Those are all drill points for oil and gas. Drill, 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 drill. Look at how many there are. And here's the San Andreas. Right here. San Andreas. All the drill points. They start right there, and then they go down, and they come right up to the San Andreas. And millions of them. Look how many there are. Every little blacked out on the ground is a different oil well. Or gas well. Mostly oil. And then they've done the whole mountain range this way. Let me show you what the mountain range used to look like. Mountain range used to look like this. Then, they came in, scraped out every hilltop, and did these. Oil and gas. And then they did the whole range that way. The whole mountain range. And then it goes back and connects into these. Okay. And that goes back and connects to these. And that goes back and connects to these. Come on, let's carry on. And that goes back and connects to these. And that goes back and connects to these. Through the farm fields. And that goes back up to the north and connects back to the San Andreas, back to the quake that we started up here. Which goes back to the San Andreas, up here. And guess what? There is a wave coming down, and when it gets down to the drill points, it's attracted over to the drill points, like a perforation in the crust. Then the wave goes.